It is now day 9 of Mauna Loa's ongoing eruption, and the eruption is still going strong despite a decrease in rate of lava fusion at the only active fissure, fissure number 3. The lava this fissure is emitting is still largely flowing to the north, causing the lobe of lava closest to Route 200 to move from 2.25 miles away from the road on December 4th to 2.16 miles away from the road on December 5th. Lava is advancing, but at an incredibly slow speed. Due to this slow speed, there is still a distinct possibility that lava will not reach the road, as if it were to continue at its negligible pace of 475 feet or 145 meters a day, it would take another 25 days to reach the road. While the lava flows are still quite molten, this fact is somewhat concealed during the day by a large proportion of cooling material. However, if you look closely, you can still see patches of orange lava. This fact becomes much more clear during the night when the orange glow of molten rock becomes more prominent. On a tangent, I wish to present what an basalt composition lava flow sounds like. And yes, it does sound like breaking glass. In other news, on December 4th, the alert level of the Mauna Loa volcano was decreased from red to orange, despite the fact that it is still erupting. Why? The reason relates to the US Geological Survey's volcano alert level system. A red alert level is generally assigned to volcanoes within the United States that are producing quantities of ash and sending it into the atmosphere in volumes sufficient enough to affect regional air traffic. In comparison, although an alert level of orange does not always indicate that a volcano is erupting, if the volcano in question is erupting, it indicates a lack of significant ash emissions into the atmosphere. During so-called Hawaiian-style effusive eruptions, minor explosive activity can occur when ignoring interaction with bodies of water or the ocean on the volcano's summit or flanks during the propagation or spreading of lava to a new fissure or vent. This occurs as intruding magma interacts with present groundwater, causing the groundwater to flash to steam. Since the same mass of steam takes up more volume than the water it once was, it causes an immense amount of pressure to build. Eventually, this pressure becomes too great and causes an upward explosion, emitting quantities of ash. However, it has been more than 48 hours since a new fissure opened or greatly expanded at Mauna Loa, so the threat to air traffic has decreased substantially, although there is still a minor hazard. However, this alert level could be raised once again in the event that another fissure or vent opens and/or explosive activity occurs. Despite the lowering of the alert level, strands of golden volcanic glass known as Pele's hair are not just being found slightly north of present lava flows. Instead, strands of Pele's hair per the US Geological Survey have even been reported as far away as 42 miles from Mauna Loa's summit and the northeast section of the Big Island. So, be on the lookout for these tiny strands of volcanic glass on the Big Island, even if you are far away from Mauna Loa's eruption. As a final note, here is a list of volcanoes within the United States which are at a raised alert level color. 4 are at an alert level color of orange, and another 4 are at an alert level color of yellow. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's top supporters on YouTube via YouTube members and patrons on Patreon.